In the last video, we took a look at the Amiga 4000T. But I ran into a problem because the machine wouldn't fully boot into Workbench, with a little help from Linux. So I'm going to copy the Workbench library file to the libs directory on my Amiga Compact Flash. So the Amiga operating system was distributed on floppy disks. Here I've got version 1.1, which came with the Amiga 1000 computer. And I've got the Amiga Extras and the Basics, and then I've got version 1.2 and 1.3, the tutorial that came with the Amiga 500. And the Amiga version 2.05, this was one that came with the Amiga 600 computer. And I've also got Workbench version 3, which was what came with my Amiga 4000. Now here I've got Workbench version 3.1. This is what came with my Amiga 1200. Now one thing about the Amiga 1200 version is my Amiga 1200 didn't come with a hard drive, so it didn't have the install disk. But what I was able to do is use the install disk from my Amiga 4000 and copy that over to work with my Amiga 1200. So on a typical Amiga, you can load Workbench through the floppy drive, but you can't do this on an Amiga 4000T, or at least without the special disk set that came packaged with the Amiga 4000T. But because my Amiga 4000T didn't come with Workbench disks, I have to load the Workbench library a little bit differently. It's possible to copy the Workbench library file to the Workbench disks, but the problem you run into is there just isn't really enough room on those disks, so you end up having to remove files from the installation disk and then trying to put them back on, and that's a bit of a pain. The second method would be to install Workbench on a standard Amiga. Anyone would work with a hard drive. After you get the Workbench installed, you can copy the Workbench library to the libs directory. Sources for the Workbench library file could include any of the old Amiga format CD-ROMs or CU Amiga CD-ROMs. They come with the Workbench library in the libs directory so that they're bootable. And you can also find the Workbench library file on the Amiga OS 3.5 upgrade CD. So here's my Amiga 4000T booted into Workbench. It was able to do that because I had already copied the Workbench library file to the hard drive, and I did that through my Linux computer. And I'm going to go into a little detail on how to go about doing that here shortly. Now, what's really interesting is the Amiga is booting from the floppy, but the floppy disk doesn't have the Workbench library file on it. But it does have it in the library file on the hard drive, so it's able to complete its boot up sequence, which really surprised me. So let me show you how I use Linux to copy the Workbench library file to my Amiga Compact Flash drive. So here's a look at my Linux desktop. I've got three windows open. The first is the root directory, and I've got the command line here, and I also have a little cheater text document that I use. I'm decent with Linux, but I'm no expert. So the first thing I'm doing is I'm creating a directory called Amiga Mount. This is where I want to mount my Compact Flash to. So I have the Compact Flash disk plugged into my USB port through a converter. And the first command I'm going to run here is fdisk. And what this is going to do is allow me to get the device name of the particular storage device. And I can do this by looking at the size of the device itself. So the next command I'm going to run is parted. So I know the device name, so I'm going to go ahead and update that in the parted command. And what parted is going to do is allow me to see the partitions that are on my Amiga drive. As you can see, the first partition is DH0, and that's a boot partition. And the second partition is called DH1. And that's how you would typically configure an Amiga drive. With Windows, you would have drive letters, and they're all treated as separate entities. But with Linux, it's more like an octopus that reaches out with all its tentacles and connects all these devices to its file system. So with the mount command, I'm going to go ahead and update the device name. So you'll notice the icon just popped up on the desktop indicating a 111 megabyte volume. This is actually my boot partition for the Amiga hard drive. And now when I click on the Amiga Mount directory, it brings me into the Amiga Compact Flash drive. Now I'm able to read the files and even write to it. So what I want to do now is copy the Workbench library file to the libs directory. I'm going to use Colanto's Amiga Forever to extract the files that I need for my Amiga 4000T. This is the premium edition, so it comes with the original ROM files, the OS files from version 1 all the way to version 3. It also comes with two DVDs with over 5 hours of video, and includes applications, demos, games, all kinds of things that would keep you busy for many, many hours. But I'm just going to use it to extract the OS files and ROMs that I want. So let's take a look at what's inside the Amiga Forever CD. Amiga, Amiga files, archives, boot, gallery, private, videos. Got an auto run, but I'm doing this on my Linux desktop. So it looks like I can boot from this. Taking a look in the libs directory, you'll notice I do not have my Workbench library that I need for the Amiga 4000T. So I've got a large collection of demos to choose from. This could keep you busy for a while. We also have several games in here. Be interesting to see if like the Deluxe Galaga, Deluxe Pac-Man are the full versions. They were originally shareware. Mega Ball as well. Shared directory. Let's see, we have some ADF files. So these are our workbench files. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a folder on my desktop. I'm going to copy the 3.1 files. Workbench directory. Now this is not the standard naming convention for the Amiga disk, so I'm not sure if I have to change the names here or not, but we'll play around with that. Amiga utilities, I don't see anything that I'm interested in. So DIR, looks like we've got a couple of pre-configured images. Let's take a look in here. We've got the libs directory, libraries directory. The one I'm particularly interested in, got the Picasso 96 library here, but I'm more interested in the Workbench library, so I'll copy that just for now. We'll put it in my Amiga directory on my desktop. Don't think I need anything else here. So this is, this could be interesting. We've got a bunch of software. Like LHA. Things like that. But I'm going to do a full install, so we're going to skip over this. So, we've got some hard files to find here. I'm not sure if this, I believe, the RDB format or not, so I'll be creating my own. And we do have some ROMs. So I'm going to grab, let's see here. So Amiga Forever has some strange ways of handling ROMs, so I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to use these ROMs or not, but I'm going to give it a go. I probably can leave them on the CD, but we'll just go ahead and grab them and throw them here for now. Let's see, Amiga 1200 ROM, I guess we'll use that one. That's about all I need from here. So I copied the Workbench library to the libs directory on my Amiga's compact flash drive, and I can tell you, this thing boots fast in about 5 seconds. I have a lot more planned for this Amiga 4000 tower, so I hope you'll join me in the next video. Take care. Goodbye.